4,
3, 2, 1.
Yeah.
This year's prom is I Remember You. I am Mickey Payton, your MC. Prom will be held at the Radisson Hotel in Evansville, Indiana, followed by an after prom party at Cottom Lanes in Muddy, Illinois. Please stay off the gymnasium floor during the promenade. That's why it's roped off. Tonight's first couple is Julie Hedrick, son of Jane and Daryl, Jane and Daryl Hedrick, escorted by Chad Pittman, son of Butch and Sheila Pittman. These are my great flags. Next couple is Susan Siss, daughter of Bonnie and James Siss, escorted by Ryan Sparrow, son of Tom and Darlene Sparrow. Next couple is Angie Fiesel, daughter of Wilson and Stella Fiesel, escorted by Brad Allen, son of Roland and Debbie Allen. Next is Angela Lynch, daughter of Roy and Marlene Lynch, escorted by Jerry Kitchen, son of Ernest and Ann Kitchen. They have some lovely outfits tonight. Lovely outfits. Next is Terry Noss, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Michael Noss, escorted by Chris Rand, son of Mr. and Mrs. Roger Graham. Next is Susan McConnell, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. James McConnell, escorted by Curtis Bradley, son of Mr. and Mrs. Lawrence Bradley. The next couple is Angie Tucker, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Jim Tucker, and Mrs. Sharon Tarleton, escorted by Donnie Prince, son of Don and Debbie Prince. Next couple is Marie Moreland, daughter of Frankie Marlborn, escorted by Teddy Brown, son of Daisy and Ray Weinstorf. Next is Tanya Crow, or Tanya Crow, daughter of Terry and Joyce Crow, escorted by Scott Rudy, son of Susie and Larry Moore. Next couple, Mary Kitchen, daughter of Ray and Ann Kitchen, escorted by Daniel Leon Berger, son of Grover and Virginia Leon Berger. Next couple, Aaron Patton, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Tom Patton, escorted by Matt Ike, son of Dr. and Mrs. Victor Ike. Next is Gina Knox, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Denny Knox, escorted by Matt Kester, son of Mr. and Mrs. Ralph Kester. Sandy Raven, escorted by Michael Bayer, son of Mr. and Mrs. Richard Bayer. Next, Amy Harrelson, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. C.L. Harrelson, Jr., escorted by Greg Doyle, son of Mr. and Mrs. Jim Doyle. Next is Andrea Bates, daughter of Miss Jill and Mike Bates, escorted by John Smith, son of Becky Chanel and Harold Smith. Next is Julie Porter, daughter of Don and Ann Porter, escorted by Damon Smith, son of Randy Walters and Jim and Kathy Smith. Escorted by Wes Henson, son of Jim and Jan Henson. Next couple, Stephanie Funkhauser, daughter of Joe and Roberta Funkhauser, escorted by Neil Hammond, son of Joe and Dolores Hammond. Next is Heather Cheryl, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Merlin Cheryl, escorted by Shannon Winters, son of Johnita Moore. Next is Jennifer Trousdale, escorted by daughter of Mr. and Mrs. John Trousdale, escorted by John Patton, son of Mr. and Mrs. Kenneth Patton. Next is Tawana Golden, daughter of Larry and Helen Golden, escorted by Terry Crow, son of Terry and Joyce Crow. Next couple is Gidget Walters, daughter of Guy and Gail Walters, escorted by Ralph Palmer, son of Ralph and Joyce Palmer. Next couple is Carla Holmes, daughter of Emma and John Holmes, escorted by Kenny Jester, son of Mr. and Mrs. Kent Jester. Next couple is Teresa Jester, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Kent Jester, escorted by Joseph Chrisom, son of Mr. and Mrs. Gary Chrisom. Next couple is Natalie Jones, daughter of Scott and Charlene Jones of Ridgeway, escorted by Rodney Emerson, son of Sandra Emerson. Escorted by Helicar Leva, son of Alfonso Leva and Olivia Leva. Escorted by Darren Donaldson, Senator Paul Littleson and Debbie Lambert. Next couple is Christy Wargo, daughter of Julie Wargo and Ron Wargo, escorted by Clint Hines, son of Mr. and Mrs. Gary Hines. Escorted by Jason Barber, son of Mr. and Mrs. Ray Barber. Escorted by Jim Monroe, son of Larry and Janet Monroe. Next couple is Christy Jackson, daughter of Joe and Helen McCarty, and Joe Jackson. Escorted by Andy Acord, son of Ed and Naomi Acord. Next couple, Amy Jones, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Gary Jones. Escorted by Ryan Wilson, son of Denny and Brenda Wilson. Next couple is Dee Dee Woods, daughter of Dion and Janet Woods. Escorted by Brian Downs, son of Rick and Marilyn Downs. Next, Julie Will, daughter of Leo and Mary Ellen Will, escorted by Ben Brockett, son of Don and Connie Brockett. Escorted by Carl Bradley, son of Bill and Phyllis Bradley. Next couple is Andrea Hughes, daughter of Paul and Cindy Hughes, escorted by Tim Aitchin, son of Mr. and Mrs. David Aitchin. Next couple is Tammy Howard, daughter of Jack and Brenda Howard, escorted by Brian Parker, son of Michael and Sharon Dahl. Next couple is Jerry Lynn Bennett, Jerry and Sonny Barger, escorted by Doug Glover, son of Terry and Pat Glover. Next couple is Christy Trice, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Roger Grace, escorted by Daryl Back, son of Mr. and Mrs. James Back. Next couple is Tara Vickery, daughter of Tara and Paula Vickery, escorted by Joy Shearer, son of Raymond and Dolores Shearer. Next couple is Stephanie Lewis, daughter of Tom and Margie Lewis, escorted by Gentry Thompson, son of Monty and Mary Thompson. Buses will be departing immediately following the promenade, so if you have any picture taking to do, I suggest you do it soon. You should be leaving Ridgeway in the next 10 to 15 minutes. Thank you. Next couple, Tara Rexing, daughter of Wayne and Joanne Rexing, escorted by Doug Cole, son of Charlie and Cheryl Rumble. Next couple, Gina Borland, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Alan Borland, escorted by Greg Hopper, son of Mr. and Mrs. Bob Hopper. Next couple is Veronica Dennison, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Ed Dennison, escorted by Jeff Lewis, son of Mr. and Mrs. Thomas Lewis. Next couple is Pat Gordon, granddaughter of Dorothy and a late former Gordon, escorted by Jim Cole, son of Susan and Wayne Lindsay. Meanwhile, here we go. Next is Reba Barger, Governor, Mr. and Mrs. Claude Gordon. Next is Lonnie Thomas, daughter of Robert and Virginia Clark. Next is Christina Wolf, daughter of John and Sharon Wolf, escorted by Jim Sinkovich, son of Tom and Pam Collins. Escorted by David Shearer, son of Fred and Susan Shearer. Next is Kara Morris, daughter of Gary and Pam Morris, escorted by Jason Bullett, son of Bud and Karen Bullett. Dobbs, daughter of Dion and Brenda Dobbs, escorted by Matthew Seeley, son of John and Kathy Seeley. Next is Chastity Berlin, daughter of Joyce Berlin, escorted by Mike Skates, son of Mark and Nancy Skates. Next is Cindy Brenneman, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Marvin Hyde, escorted by Derek Prom, son of Mr. and Mrs. Don Prom. Next is Susie Skates, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Stephen Skates, escorted by Wes Bradley, son of Mr. and Mrs. Lawrence Bradley. Next is Carla Fromm, daughter of Jim and Jenny Fromm, escorted by Jason Mosall, son of Mike and Ellen Mosall. Next is Angela Falls, daughter of Steve and Sheila Falls, escorted by Jason Stacy, son of Mr. and Mrs. Joe Stacy. Next couple is Debbie Falls, daughter of Mr. of Cedric and Nancy Falls, escorted by Bill Wenzel, son of Mr. and Mrs. Rodney Wenzel. Next is Brenda Winarski, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Bob Clark. It's going to be Mike Phillips, son of Mr. and Mrs. Morris Phillips. Next is Edward Raster, son of John and Sharon Raster. This completes the formal part of the promenade. We've been a wonderful audience. Let us give you some picture taking today in Cornwallville for I Remember You. Thank you.
You know how many times we've been, everybody's been together? You're missing out. Wait.
No, I got things
wrong. Wes is coming down in a
minute.
Embarrassed me the other day.
He don't even have an arm. There's
you
no light.
You did this. Okay. Too much.
Gina, move back here.
Hi, Grandma.
You guys
mind?
Come on.
She didn't touch my one.
She wanted it that way.
Hey, pretty good, Jim.
Are you going to graduate, Mark?
That thing out of here.
Hi, sir. What's your name?
Tim Aitchin.
Where are you from?
El Dorado.
You having a good time?
No.
Hey, that's because he's with Hughes.
I'm Andrea Hughes.
You having a good time, Andrea?
Not yet.
She's having a good time because she's with me. My name's Brian Parkhurst. That's Andrea Hughes.
Her name? Tell me your name.
Tammy Howard.
Where are you from?
Shinytown. This was my date.
It was, yeah. Hi, what's your name?
Becky Skate.
You having a good time?
Yep.
Hi, what's your name?
Samantha Rushing.
Where are you from?
Shawneetown.
Shawneetown, you having a good time?
Pretty good.
Hi, what's your name?
Mariah Foster.
You having a good time?
Yeah.
Who's your date here?
This is Wes Henson.
You having a good time?
See.
Hi, what's your name?
Jason Vallette.
Where are you from?
Equality.
And what's your name?
Tim Monroe.
Who's your date this evening?
Andrea Hobbs.
Are you having a good time?
I'm having a blast.
What's your name?
Joel Christen.
Are you from Shinytown?
Yeah.
And who's your date?
Teresa Jessica.
Let's see. How are you girls doing tonight? Are you having a good time?
Yeah.
And are you juniors or seniors?
Junior.
Kenny what?
Jessica.
What's your name?
Carla Holmes.
Are you having a good time?
Yeah.
Keep homie.
And my name's Kara Morris. Yes, I'm having a good time.
Excuse me, Pat. Excuse me. What's your name?
Fat Kester.
And where are you from?
Ridgeway, Illinois.
And who's your date?
Quit.
I don't know which one it is. Tina Noss.
I'm his cousin.
And what's your name? What's your
Daryl Back.
Aren't you the famous pitcher from Shinytown?
Yes, the very famous one. The very famous one.
And where are you going to go on to play for pros?
Well, a few major league teams have looked at me. And
which one?
Let's see, the Cardinals, maybe. You know, they're okay. And maybe the Mets this year. It's just according, you know, the way I feel, what mood I'm in. Just things like that, you know.
So who do you think's the best-looking girl here tonight?
About the money. What
Well, yeah, the money. Excuse me.
Never mind.
Never mind. Okay, thank you.
Excuse me.
What's your name?
Shannon Winters.
And where are you from?
Quality.
And who's your escort?
Heather Terrell.
Tell me about her.
Tell you about her?
Yeah.
Well, she's 18. She works at Sizzler in Evansville. What else you want to know?
How you feel about her?
How do I feel about her? I like her a lot.
You just like her?
I feel like I'm on Geraldo or something. Hell, I don't know.
Christy Wargle.
Are you having fun?
Yes.
Where are you from?
Ridgeway.
Oh, how old are you?
17.
Come here, Clint. Come here. What's your name?
Clint Hines.
Are you having a good time?
Great.
So far?
Yes.
Where are you going to school at?
Gallatin County.
Chad! What are you having fun?
Well, I had a great time. What do you think?
What? Ryan, you want this interview?
Nah, I'd like to refrain from that this
What's
year.
From?
Okay, well, Matt?
Tara Raven.
Yeah, I'm having a real good time.
Where are you from?
I'm Barbara Harrelson. I'm from Equality.
Are you having a good time tonight?
Yeah, so far.
I'm ready to start dancing.
Well, what's your name, sir?
Gary Bear from Ridgeway.
Are you having fun tonight?
Yeah.
My name's Jim Borden. From?
I'm 18. My name's Greg Hopper, and I'm from Equality.
Are you having a good time tonight?
Yeah.
What's your name? Where are you from?
Gina Borland, and I'm from Equality.
Are you having a good time?
I guess.
Harry Kitchens, Shawnee Town.
Are you having a good time tonight?
Not really.
Hi, guys.
Are you having a most excellent time?
Are you having a most excellent time?
A most excellent time. But you're right.
I enjoyed the trip to the bathroom.
Well, let's walk around, you know, talk to a few people out here. How about you, Susan?
Excellent.
Hey, dude, come here. Right. We're in a blast here.
That's right, buddy.
Hey, Mikey.
This is awesome.
This is a dude from Chinatown. His name is Mikey Skates. He hates me, but I love him. Look at that face. Well, Mikey, you want to take us over? Hey, Pat, this is another one of my friends, Mr. Kester. How you doing, Mr. Kester?
Yeah. I don't know. Like,
I'm having a wonderful time.
Really?
Are you?
Not really, but this is why I'm doing this job. How about this dude here? I don't know this guy. Brian. What's your name?
Brian.
Brian what?
Parkhurst.
Where are you from?
Harrisburg.
Harrisburg. Well, hands dirty, all right. Chad Pittman from Ridgeway. Having fun?
Yeah, having a good time.
Really? What'd you eat here?
Not much.
Them green beans look like they just come out of the field or something, don't
they?
I know. Well, other food is pretty
kinda
good.
Raw. Yeah, the ham was good.
Yeah, it was. Come here. I don't know this guy here. What's your name, sir?
Brian Parkhurst.
Where are you from, Brian?
Harrisburg.
That's most excellent. Glad to meet you.
Nice to meet you. What about you?
I am too.
Hey, we call this girl Stinky. I don't know why. How you doing, Stinky?
Just fine.
What do you say, Jerry? You already been on the camera, gal.
Yeah.
There's Doug. Let's go over and talk to Doug. How you doing, Doug?
All right, how you doing, Chad?
Yeah, most excellent time or what?
It's awesome.
Awesome.
Right? Yeah, it's awesome.
Well, you got to say, Tara.
Not much.
Not much.
That's just Tara, not much. Hey, Stoney.
What do you say, Chad?
Not much. What's going
on? Hey, you want a job?
Yeah.
Yeah, here you go. Yeah, let's go over here. Hey, Stephanie, who are you going out with?
Who?
Somebody.
Norman.
I am
Norman.
Not.
You're going out with Norman.
Her Norman,
right? Uh-oh. Here, let me see this.
No.
Wait.
Wait. Can we see the boneless chicken? You want to see the boneless chicken?
No. Maybe later. Maybe later.
Let's see the boneless chicken.
Maybe later.
And then we're going to proceed with the king and queen coronation. Would you please be seated? Would you please be seated? All right, I got you covered. Please be seated. Thank you. John? John Schmidt? Is anybody else in the hall? John? Is everybody in?
Yeah, everybody's
in. Okay, my pleasure to introduce Ms. Stephanie Funkhauser.
Good evening. My name is Stephanie Funkhauser. I'm president of the junior class of the Ridgeway Attendance Center. On behalf of the junior class, I would like to welcome the Board of Education, the administration, the faculty, and the juniors and seniors to the 1990 prom. I would like to congratulate and welcome the senior class of 1990 to this prom, which is in your honor. Now I would like for the Queen and King announcers to please come forward.
Good job.
Buenos dias. Okay, the Ridgeway prom king of 1990 is Mr. Chad Pittman.
The Ridgeway 1990 prom queen is John Smith. The Shawneetown Queen is Andrew Hughes.
Don't look too early.
get things going, and then feel free to join in. Here's Skid Row.
Love with my baby, see you. I feel like.
ourselves some and we're gonna get the party going. It's Japanese.
Well, you're looking in the sky tonight. And every guy has got you here inside. What you're doing with the crowd like me? The shorty wore a nice little Mr. B.
Wait a minute.
Go, Freddy.
Go!
Stay. makes her faces a wicked. She thinks she kinda cute, so she winks back. And now you're feeling really proud, cause the girl is stacked. Reception's jumping, faces pumping. Look at the girl and your heart starts thumping. Says she wanna dance to a different group. Now you don't want to do it till you bust the book.
Hey. Alright, hopefully everybody's getting along so much.
Taking care of business, every day. Taking care of business, every way.
off. You want to get your picture taken, you better do so now. Also, faculty, if you are interested in getting your picture taken, faculty, if you want to get your picture taken, head on up and now. It's James Giles.
County High School's I Remember You. Skid Row, your theme there. Tony Kauscher from GBF here in Evansville. And the time of the evening, it has been approached. It's time for the class prophecies. That is right. The class prophecies. We're going to do that, and I guess we'll be back into the music here in just a little while. Okay.
Hold the mic close to your mouth and go slow. You got it. Thank you. Hello. The mic is close.
Can everybody hear me?
All right.
Here we go.
Don't be the side. Let's just show you.
Has it on?
Yes.
Can everybody hear me?
Speak up. You got a lot of back.
Okay, I'm Julie Hedrick, and this is Susan McConnell, and we're going to read the class prophecies, and we're from Ridgeway High School.
Get your mic a little closer.
Okay, in 10 years from now, Pat Kester took Ms. King's position as English teacher at Gallatin County High School. His prize pupil will be Eric Ambrose, who never got out of English 3.
Matt Iatt's occupation was a tough decision. But instead of following in his father's footsteps, he became a big hit in the carnival circuit with his flame show. The highlight of the act is when Matt leaps through the flame as his assistant Aaron throws gasoline on the fire.
Pat Gordon starts her own advice column Gallatin Democrat called Patty Knows.
Ted Bowles makes it big and is better known as Jocko Jr. Then later returns to Gallatin County to become a band teacher and preacher.
Gina Borland became the first woman to hold the WFM belt for 15 years in a row, World Female Mud Wrestle Federation.
Rich Zirkleball designs a more soothing and comfortable hot tub and is making millions from his success.
Beth Green lives with Buddy Bean, but is harassed by Jennifer Trisdale because of her earlier romance with Dirk Crawford that she still is envious of.
Continues to spread peace and love throughout Shawneetown and Florida and organizes Woodstock 2.
After high school, Andy Eggert, he started teaching a special kind of karate class, how to break glass windows without cutting yourself.
Greg Hopper. After graduation, Greg remembered all the high school gossip he was involved in. So now he is the rich owner of the Gallatin County Enquirer. His famous article is, Busybodies Wanna Know.
Doug Glover is sued after winning the gold medal for wrestling for his new WrestleMania doll, Glovey, for giving many children nightmares for his scary looks.
Teresa Jester, the homecoming queen, was last seen barefooted walking on a country road, begging for a glass of water.
Ronnie Gulledge. After graduation, Ronnie kept working at the Mad Pricer and soon became known as the big dog of the Mad Pricer and now owns all the Mad Pricers across the world.
Eddie Reister has become the Alpo Dog Food National Spokesman.
Becky Skates marries Tom Watson, has 10 kids, and is currently living at Big Lake.
Kim Wood takes aviator lessons after attempting to fly out of a window of a two-story house.
Tara Raven shocked us all and turned from her wicked ways and looked to God for guidance. She joined a convent and is now known as Sister Tara.
Joel Johnson is now in the book of world records for having the most tattoos.
Lucy McClure, the only student in the class of 1990 that becomes a success by marrying a wealthy millionaire and rebuilds old Shawneetown and it becomes a theme park, Shawneeland.
Tammy Howard marries Brian and they go on welfare due to his inability to keep a job. So she divorces him because she can't have designer clothes. Years later, she remarries Chris Downing and they open up their own hot tub company.
Gentry Thompson finally made it to the big leagues, not as an excellent catcher, but as a new mascot for the Dodgers as the Boneless Chicken.
Michelle Grom became an engineer for Ford Motor Company designing mufflers.
Chris Wolf becomes an accountant and marries Jimmy.
Robin Heffington. Roche leaves her because he finds out of her early romance in PE class that still lingers with Jean Jay.
Tanya Crow has been known not to be very sneaky when it comes to skipping out. Now she owns her own Skip Out Foundation for runaway teenagers.
Shannon Winters. The day of graduation came and Mr. Disney told Shannon he was not going to graduate because of all the money he owes in the library. The year is now 2020 and Shannon still owes $500.
Tracy Moore, Jimmy Sharp, now an old man, proposes to her, but instead of accepting, she lets her parents buy her a new ruby red escort wagon.
Tara Vickery becomes a nuclear pharmacist and searches for the cure for cancer. And Tommy Gordon gladly volunteers to be her guinea pig.
Terry Noss. After graduation, Terry worked out and became a weightlifter, and then went to El Dorado to find the girl who spilled beer on her and beat her up.
Angela Lynch. After graduation, Angela moved to Hollywood to become an actress. She has now taken over Joan Collins' job and star on Dynasty.
Jean Joyner convicted for robbing the cradle, but gets out of jail in enough time to watch her boyfriend graduate from high school.
Stephanie Blair will be married with two sons and will only work with husband Matt McCure at Rudy's Pork Palace.
Brenda Winarski decided since she wrote the Constitution so many times in high school that she would change her name to James Monroe and write a new Constitution.
Jim Borland, of course, marries Barb. And they had 20 kids and started their own daycare center.
Kenny Jester owns a chain of shell stations across the U.S. and wins the battle with the Exxon Valdez of the latest oil spill.
Lisa Rice marries Cletus McGee, but Cleet has a romance with longtime love, Lisa Barton, so they divorce.
Was such a good English student that after graduation he decided to become a poet. He now has beat out Longfellow and Poe with his famous poems.
Barb Harrelson. After her marriage with Jim, she had a nervous breakdown and was admitted to an insane asylum.
Tawana Golden marries high school love Terry Crow and finally becomes Miss County Board and cries and laughs her way to sleep at nights for her husband's harsh cruelty and jealousy of her friend.
Ryan Rushing currently lives in Tijuana with his chica and owns Taco Bell Incorporated.
Angie Faisal married Brad and they opened their own Quick Vic because Brad loves to pump gas.
Jennifer Trousdale, after graduation, becomes a salesman for Anderson Windows. The window model she recommends and his personal favorite is the kind that is guaranteed not to make a sound for easy opening and closing.
Bill Wenzel works as a janitor in the Gallatin County School District for most part of his life. He also releases the country classic, Older Women Make Better Lovers.
Reba Barker becomes a country singer and makes Old Town famous in the latest hot spot.
Jerry Kitchen works at Pop's Rock Popcorn as a janitor and won the Janitor of the Year award.
Julie Porter becomes an aeronautics engineer at NASA. In the following year, her life was destroyed when Damon dumped her. She hijacked a space shuttle and threatened to blow up the world with a nuclear warhead, but accidentally blowing up herself.
Samantha Rushing, after winning the Cold Days Queen crown, she goes on to be the first woman mud wrestler from Shawneetown.
Anita Kennedy marries a state cop and opens up a car repair shop.
Jeff Holland became a stockbroker in New York on Wall Street.
Rodney Dillinger, he opened his own restaurant called Lug Nuts. His specialty is all the lug nuts you can eat.
John Smith, Fragile, becomes an orthopedic surgeon after all the other accidents with his broken legs, arms, etc., and is in the Guinness Book of World Records for the longest nails.
Andrea Hughes opens her new exclusive jean corporation called River Rip Jeans. She also is convicted of bigamy for the many marriages she has had in Harrisburg and El Dorado.
Doug Goble, he is so fond of speaking on the emergency hotline that he became the dispatcher of the Gallatin County Sheriff Department.
Veronica Dennison designed a new kind of bar, an outdoor bar with a bar stool to sit on so people won't sit on strange things.
Alanya Thomas stars in the Nair Short Shorts commercial and owns her own new design of jeans.
John Patton became a surrogate love letter writer since he was so good at writing love letters to himself when he was a freshman.
Chris Abel married Rhonda and became a pro basketball player.
Ryan Sparrow. After graduation, Ryan became a car dealer so that he'll have a new car to drive when he wrecks his new one.
April Milton, we're up here reading all the senior class prophecies, and now we're going to read yours. Is that all right?
Todd Goforth won the high jump in the Olympics. After his awesome win, he was checked for steroids, and he tested positive. He got his medal taken away and put in the Betty Ford Clinic.
Chad Pittman married Julie, got a divorce, then they got married again, and got another divorce, and so on.
Stephanie Lewis. She graduated, then she remembered the time in first grade when she dribbled. So she invents a new school desk with a toilet seat.
Oh my. Tara Rexing graduated and remembered the time in grade school when she told Amy Street to meet her behind the school and locked up all the underclassmen in the bathroom, calling them bozo. So she decided to become a professional boxer.
Kara Woods graduated from medical school and is living on a raccoon farm in Harco with her husband Bruce and four children. In her spare time, she is trying to find a cure for the strange rash that innocent girls get on their hands while playing in the woods.
Ann Islett is still cruising Harrisburg chasing bikers and being chased by little black girls who aren't so little anymore and now are in cars instead of bikes.
Anita Woods. She is still going to Shawneetown looking for her diamond ring and going honky-tonking at Glenn L. Jones.
Mike Bear will live in the woods in his house with his dog and his wife. He will go fishing all day, and no matter what, he'll always be in Gumby Land.
James Farler killed all the pigs in his yard so that he could open up his own barbecue stand and call it Foogie's Barbecue.
Kara Morris became a soap opera star in Days of Our Lives. She came across this job because of her ability to act at Ridgeway High School. They gave her a lifetime contract.
Brian P. Jones. Because of all the country singing he did in P.E., he decided to become a country singer and piano player. He now has a number one hit on the country charts and is beating out Hank Williams Jr. Last but not least, he is married to his high school sweetheart, Crystal.
Patty Winslow decides she didn't learn one thing in high school, so at the last day of school, she quit. She now buys savings bonds, hoping one day she'll get rich off them.
Eric Wilson, he designed the first calculator that has all math classes printed on it. He became so rich off his invention that he got bored and took over Mr. Smith's job and gave every class one of his calculators so no one had to study again.
Lori Clark moved to Harrisburg and married her man. She decided since she did so well in accounting that she would become an accountant and now has lots of children just so she can count them.
Jason Bosaw, he decided to become a movie director because of all the taking he did while in high school.
Beth Bamberger went to college and she flunked out, so she decided since Bamberger rhymes with hamburger, she would open her own restaurant named Beth Bamberger's Hamburgers.
David Baldwin, he has been mowing lawns for so long and does such a good job that he owns his own business in Ridgeway called Baldwin's Lawn Service, and it became one of the most prosperous businesses in Ridgeway.
Jason Bullitt decided that being tied down to one girl was a drag, so he moved to California to check out all the girls. While in the process, he got a contract with Playgirl. He is now married to Madonna and expecting his first child.
Oh my. Amy Street. She was tired of being so sweet and innocent, so she decided to open her own bar and new dance club, and she is the main dancer. Okay, we would also like to thank our class sponsors for all the help they gave us. Mr. Drone, Mr. Schmidt, Ms. Sachs, and Mr. Winders.
We'd like to thank our class sponsors too, Mr. Panky, Ms. Nussbaum, Mr. Abel, and Ms. Gates. Thank you.
Okay, now we know what you've been waiting for since 7:30. We're going to turn it over to Mr. Cub, Derek Fromm, for the garter ceremony. Look out! Oh my! Get ready! Louder! Louder!
Well, I don't know if I can follow them prophecies, buddy. They were funny, wasn't they?
Yeah.
All right, now let's get busy here. No offense, North City. Okay, we're gonna get this started. Everybody come up and make a half circle like, and we'll get this thing rolling. All
right.
What a guy.
There.
All right, now let's get serious. No, not that serious now. So. Okay, boys, get down on your right knee. The right one, Greg, not the left one. Okay. All right. Now, girls, I want you to be careful now. I know this is tricky, but you're going to put your leg on Doug's leg. Crowd, let's give a hand to the Prom committee and all the Prom sponsors. and I'm kind of nervous, so I'll wrap it up.
One more quick announcement. At 11:15, they'll be out in the hall running around. We're going to have a twist contest, and the winners will be pictured in the yearbook. So we're going to twist again at 11:15. Teachers, you can't win. Okay, this is for the students. Tony's going to crank the music back up. Take it, Tony. Let's go.
Like those that lied with the hunt. Rolling down the street, I saw a girl when she was pumping. I winked my eyes, got into the ride, went to a club and jumping. Introduced myself to Lo, she said, you're a liar. I said, I got it going on, baby girl, and I'm a liar. Took her to the hotel, she said, you're the king. I said, be my queen, if you know what I mean.
looking good, but I think we should twist again.
Losers, you just knew not winners if you're not still out there. Couple number one of the finalists is Daryl Back and Stephanie Bungallinger. Couple number two is Daniel Leonberg and his lovely lady. What's your name? Mary Kitchen. Couple number three is Miss Jones and her date. Natalie Jones. Who's her date? Mr. Zuckerball. Now, well, hey, listen now. The audience is now involved. Pay attention, everybody. Because after this one, hey, we're going to do it by applause of the audience to pick the winners. We're going to twist one more time like we did last summer. Audience, pay attention. Hit Tony.
Yeah. They're all good. Now here's what we're going to do. Mr. Taxi himself, Pat Abel, is going to hold a hand over a couple. You applaud. And Miss Sachs and Miss Nussbaum and Mr. Winders will make a decision on the winner. So clap loud for your favorite. And let's go, Mr. Abel. Get to it, Miss Sachs. Okay, we're going to do it again. Two more times. Here we go. We got one to go. Would say that's the winner. Your winning couple is in the middle. They're the big twisters of that. They're the big twisters of 1990. After we get their pictures, we got about 30 more minutes when they're on the stretch, so let's get your dancing done. Are you talking? What are we going to do? We're going to get on those beautiful yellow buses at 12 midnight. We're going to all turn into pumpkins. Thank you.
Yeah. buddy.
Three.
Prom video from Kingery Productions. And the winner of a free prom video is Mariah Foster. Mariah. Okay, now we got some money to give away here. We're gonna give away four $20 bills here to four different people.
Jill Wood, won $20. Come on up, get you $20. Jill Wood.
oceans apart, day after day, and I slowly go insane. I hear your voice on the line, but it doesn't stop the pain. If I see you next to never, then how can we say forever? Wherever you go, whatever you do, I will be right here waiting for you. Whatever it takes, or how my heart breaks, I will be right here waiting for you.
Through every endless day, I wanna
What you're doing with a clown like me is surely one of life's little mysteries. Only you can see.